And I look in your eyes, I feel alive. Some days we say words that don't mean a thing.
Hey, what's up, you guys? New video, hair not done, obviously. Y'all can see Raelynn's little head right here. A little disclaimer, I broke my tripod, so okay. The angle of this video is going to look kind of weird.
You
want
to say hi?
Say hi. Look, mama, say hi. Okay, so by the title of this video, you guys can see I'm going to be talking about how I maintain my teenage life while being a mother, because you guys know I am 18. I'm a senior in high school, and I have a 8-month-old. So, you know, a lot of people say you throw away your teenage life, like having a baby at a young age. No, not with me. And I'm going to tell you guys how I maintain that. So if you guys see me looking down, it's because I have my iPad right here. And I just have about like 4 little things that help me maintain my teenage life. So yeah, let me jump into the video. Okay, so the first thing is I get 2 weeks without her. Me and her father have a schedule where we each keep her for 2 weeks, and then, you know, the other person keeps her for 2 weeks. And so, you know, I get a 2-week break without her. And so within them 2 weeks, I'm able to do whatever I want, you know? Like, I don't have to just sit around the house. Like, I can go out and do stuff with my friends. I could just, you know, go as I please. So that's one of the main things. And that's why I'm so happy me and her dad have a good relationship, because not even a good relationship. I'm happy she has an active father, because he's the reason that I'm able to do that. So yeah, that's one of the main topics. The next one is I don't let her get in the way of friends coming over or wanting to go out with friends. I never went out with friends with her. Like, I never went anywhere with my friends with her. But if I wanted to, I could. Like, if I wanted to go to the mall, if I wanted to go out to eat or something, I can take her with me. You know, like, she's not stopping it. The only thing I wouldn't take her to is if I'm going somewhere like the movies, or if I'm going to play golf, or you know something I can't really bring a baby to. That's the only thing those are the only things I wouldn't really bring her to, because she can go everywhere with me, you know? Like, she doesn't stop anything, especially from friends coming over. Like, she doesn't stop that. My friends can come over, they love seeing Raelynn, even though Raelynn doesn't be as happy to see them. She likes seeing them. So that's very important. Like, don't let your child stop you from doing stuff or having people come over. The third one is having a babysitter. I'm not gonna say a babysitter, but sometimes within me and her father's 2 weeks, sometimes we just need like one day away from her. It's really rare that it happens, actually, because I haven't done it in a while and he hasn't done it in a while. So it's very rare that it happens. But you know, like, sometimes within them weeks, I may ask him like, hey, can you keep her for a day? Like, I just need a break. Or if I have something to do, I can always ask her dad like, hey, can you watch her for like 2 hours? I want to go out and do this and that and that and this. Now, whether or not he'll agree, I don't know. But majority of the time, I know he will, because I would do the same thing for him. And also, if like needed, if I really did need a break away from her, then my mom would watch her. But I really actually don't get anybody. I don't get anybody to like watch her, because I want to go out and do stuff. Like, sometimes when me and her dad want to run to like the store or the mall, her aunt will watch her. But like, that's just about it. Like, I don't really ask anybody to watch her so I can go do this, that, and that, you know? Another thing is being online for school. This one has really saved my life, because you know, it saves me on money of having to put her in daycare or having to pay somebody to watch her. That really saves me. And it just makes stuff so much easier because I don't have to attend Zoom calls. And that's one of the main things right there. I don't have to attend Zoom calls, and all my work is usually on Google Classroom or College Board, mainly Google Classroom though. And so, you know, it's like I just get up, get on the computer and do it, and I do it when I feel like it. So, you know, that makes it a lot easier. Like, don't get me wrong, stuff is due at a certain time, so I do have to get stuff turned in, but I can mainly do all my work when I feel like it. And so when she's here, I can do it while she's playing or if she's asleep or, you know, just preoccupied. So that one really saves me. Although I did think about going back to school next semester, I would still possibly have somebody to watch her. So, you know, that being online for school, although it's my senior year, it really made it easier for me. I'm low-key glad that that happened. But, yeah, you guys, I know this was a short video, but I just wanted to let you guys know how I managed to balance my teenage life and my, being a mother. And, yeah, I don't let this get in the way of anything, like, talking to somebody, dating somebody, you know, stuff like that. I don't let that get in the way of it. Although I'm not doing either of those things, I don't let it get in the way of it. So yeah, if you stayed to the end of this video, thank you so much for watching. Say thank you. Y'all, she did not like talking on camera. I don't know why. But yeah, you guys, we'll see you guys in our next video. Goodbye.